the Writers Trust for giving this award and for all the amazing work they do for Canadian writers. In the Canadian literary world, I've really found a true home. And I want to thank all the editors and writers in Canada who've consistently published my essays over the years and have challenged me on my thoughts and ideas, and they've made me a better fiction writer. And thank you to everyone in CanLit who works for almost nothing. The minute one of us has an existential crisis and asks what it's all for, it's going to come crashing down. But we don't, because it's such a beautiful thing to live in imaginary worlds. I want to thank everyone at HarperCollins for publishing my books all these years and being such a wonderful and supportive literary home, especially to Jennifer Lambert, who's been editing my books for so many years. Even though I hand them in like shoeboxes covered in cake, she totally helps me craft my novels into stories. If it were not for her, my books would just seem like children's books annotated by Humbert Humbert. And she always answers my question at the end of each book. I'm like, just tell me the truth, honestly. Does this book suck or what? And she gives me the mojus. And as I'm constantly harassing her, I know she edits other books, but I can't picture it. And I think I'm going to use this money to hire a detective to see what she does when she's not editing my books. And thank you to my daughter, Arizona, my trusted sidekick, who I always made come on research journeys with me. I made her drag suitcases around and ride buses in the middle of the night when she was little, making her come with me. From documenting swans and paddle boats in the park and freak shows on Coney Island to ending up at literary festivals in London. You made everything banal seem like an adventure and every strange adventure like a place where we belong. Thank you also to my parents, although I'm always hesitant to thank you because they were totally neglectful and abusive. But there's nothing like having compulsive liars and con artists for parents to teach you the ins and out of creating a persona and backstories out of scratch, and that spinning a lovable lie is the basis for getting anyone to love you undeservedly. And especially to my dad, who as a child used to dictate letters to people he wanted to kill to me. And when I told him it was not syntactically possible to use the word fuck so many times in a sentence, he told me, never mind the fancy shit. Put it fucking down like it fuck it is. And I thought, oh, I will grow up and I will write that fancy stuff one day. And thank you to all my elementary school teachers who put gold stickers all over my stories and were convinced I had a gift when all I remember about myself is asking to go to the bathroom to wipe dog shit off my running shoes and trying to get tennis balls on the roof of the school. But they were all convinced I would grow up to be a writer and they gave me compliments. And I don't think I knew then what a compliment was, and it like terrified me. But anyways, I thank them now. And thank you to my boyfriend, Patrick. I think I totally invented him, but he thinks he's real and believes. He believes in his backstory and that he had this whole life before I thought him up in a notebook and made him up with a pen, which is to say, I couldn't imagine anyone more perfect. And thank you to all my stupid characters who I put out in the world and who went looking for readers to fall in love with. I gave them each a partner to keep them company in this make-believe world. Having been a lonely child with no one to understand me except some strange characters in books, I don't know what made me so convinced I had self-worth, but I found it on my own. And I knew if I could see beauty, there was something beautiful about me, because every examined life is beautiful. Thank you.